Freddy from Switzerland with another knife video, and today we have episode 8 of our show and tell video series powered by Tell Knives from Switzerland, which is a knife retailer here from Switzerland, from the French-speaking region of Switzerland actually, that has some good prices for Switzerland and Europe, as well as a great selection and some very good customer service. And I'm very happy that they reached out to me and making this series possible. These are more overview videos because these knives, of course, need to go back to the reseller in resellable fashion. And I can choose a couple of knives that they sent to me for these show and tell videos. And in exchange, I present their store here on YouTube. And they are really great people to talk to and have a great selection and really understand something about knives. And so I would highly recommend to check their website out as well as their Instagram. Everything will be linked down here in the description box as always, and check out all my older show and tell videos on some very interesting knives from very well-known brands. So please check out the playlist of all the show and tell videos that I have done so far. Now let's get to the knife that will be featured in today's episode, and that is this one here, a newer V-knife, the V-knife's Eilidon, which is another Justin Lundquist design. You can see here Justin Lundquist's logo, and here's the V logo as we expected on the pivot screw right there. And this is a very, very interesting and cool knife because it's actually an integral. This here is a gray G10 integral, but there is also a full carbon fiber integral available as well, and there is also a black G10 integral handle available, and there is a different blade shape. Here we have the nice drop point blade shape with a hollow grind primary bevel right there. Nice swatch at the top in this gorgeous stonewash finish. And there is also a dagger grind available as well on these Eilidon models. And you can see this is of course a front flipper or top flipper design that really works exceptionally well. This is probably the easiest front or top flipper to manipulate that I have handled so far. And this is actually quite a new model from V-Knives, just released, and really cool that a Swiss store actually has these for sale. So that's certainly speaking to the quality in terms of supply chain that Tell Knives has. And I'm very happy that I actually can check out this knife, because this is certainly something that I would like to have in the collection, since it's a very nice gentleman's carry, great office urban style carry, still getting a good amount of blade length and a great steel. This is actually CPM 20CV in terms of the steel. I haven't found an area where they actually have marked that, but it is CPM 20CV, which is a great steel. I actually probably prefer it over M390, which is chemically identical, but on the knives I had 20CV, it was more impressive in terms of its performance, but it certainly isn't a big difference. I just really like when people use 20CV. And overall, just a great compact front flipper here. And let's do the specs on this Eilidon model. So we have an overall length of 6.58 inches or 16.7 centimeters with a blade length of 2.86 inches or 7.26 centimeters, a blade stock of 3.2 millimeters, as I said before, CPM 20CV for the blade steel with a hollow grind and a stonewash finish. And we have a handle length of 3.75 inches or 9.4 centimeters. Weight wise, this comes in super, super lightweight, since you only have the blade that is steel and then a one-sided liner lock, as well as the pocket clip that is probably also steel, or this could actually be titanium. And weight wise, it's just 62 grams or 2.18 ounces. So super lightweight while still managing to be a full four-finger knife. You know, I wear a size 7.5 sterile glove, so a small to medium hand, and it fits my hand very well in this saber grip. This is probably more the way you will hold it, and it works really well like that. Of course, a hammer grip is no problem as well. and reverse grip is also possible because it's a super, super standard handle. No real curves or anything, just a very, very minimalist handle here. And it flares a tiny bit to the back right there, which I just noticed here. And it's certainly a thicker handle because it's an integral. So for the overall form factor, this really is a bit of a thick boy in comparison here. For example, the IQ from Quiet Carry, this is certainly much, much thinner in the pocket. But that is something you have to keep in mind because it's an integral, they need a bit more width here. The G10 is very nicely milled, very, very symmetrical, everything. One thing I noticed that surprised me a little bit was around the areas of these white G10 pivot collars. Is here on this side, it is done very well. So you see everything fits nicely, even though it's completely contoured. So there is no real edges or misfits here on the pivot collars. You can feel a bit of a transition in some areas, but it's very, very minute. But on the other side, it's not that well done. You can see here the difference in height and it doesn't really fit together very well. And that's something I hadn't expected from Wii knives, and this is something that I really don't like. You can see that the contouring of the G10 doesn't really interface well with the pivot screw there, so that is a bit disappointing fit and finish right here. But everything else is done super well. You can see here the integral nature, how they fitted the steel liners. There is actually a liner on the non-locking side, but just in the top area here around the pivot area, because you need some steel interface there and it doesn't really extend a lot. So here it's just G10, as you can see right there, and of course the one-sided liner. And the pocket clip is done very, very well here. You can see you have no screws visible from the outside, just underneath the clip some very, very tiny just the screw ends. So it's actually screwed in from the inside probably. Let's take a look. Here are the screw heads. So it's actually screwed in from the inside and there is nothing interfering with your pocket material. It's not super high, so you actually need to have some slightly thinner pants, but it worked very well on the pants that I wear, or most of the pants that I wear, the ones that I tried it out. Good ramp, a bit stiff, but it actually wasn't really an issue, probably because it's a thinner clip, so you can actually bend it quite a bit. And it worked really well on the pants I tried it. And of course, it's a very smooth G10, so very easy to slide it in and out of the pocket. Also, some nice fine media blasted finish on that pocket clip. Very nice interface here, nothing overstanding. So overall fit and finish is great. Just this area here has a bit of issues going on. If you have an eyelet on, let me know if yours has the same issue in this area right here. Flipper area right here, very nicely trimmed, very, very minimal. You almost don't see it if you don't look for it, and it works very well with this kind of reach around method, very easy to do. Then you have the thumb deployment, of course, that works equally as well, and it runs very smooth, but it's a very light blade. So you can see now it fell down, but it's not super, super free falling, but it's very, very smooth. It runs, of course, on captured ceramic bearings and it runs really well on them, but it's just not a heavy blade, so it's not going to fall completely shut just with the weight of the blade. Centering is perfectly done as well. And lockup we can show perfectly as well. And of course you have a hidden stop pin right there peeking through. And on the blade there is no real markings, as you have seen, just the Justin Lundquist logo. And there you can see the CPM20CV. It's super small, just here at the Ricasso. The grind clears nicely, the plunge grind. You get just a very thin actual bevel right there. And it's very, very sharp out of the box. You get a nice and functional thin tip. Great for EDC, great for leather opening, package opening. That is something I really value in an EDC that I actually carry. A nice puncture tip like we have it here. Of course, nothing to pry with. And you can see in the hand, it fits really well. It's very nice to the touch with that G10 material. And it's just very comfortable, no hotspot from that clip. And now let's do some size comparison so you can get a good feel for the size of the Eilidon. So we have our Shirogorov Sandwich F95NL at the top and Neon Zero at the bottom. And you can see it's smaller than both of these knives for sure. And then we have our Benchmark EDC blades. We have the full-sized Bug Out by Benchmade and the Para 3 by Spyderco, and you can see it's smaller than both of these as well. If you take a look at the cutting edge though, you see it's the same or even a slightly bit more cutting edge than a Para 3, just in a much more compact package, especially when you compare it to the package in the pocket. So very, very, it's about half the thickness there in terms of carry, but of course you don't get that super ergonomic hand feeling feel in hand as you have it on a Para 3, but these are probably not direct contenders for your pocket. These are very, very different knives. Some other comparisons that are more in the same vein than the Justin Lundquist and Weknives Eilidon here are, for example, the Brad Zinker Urban Trapper Arc Full Custom, a great front flipper that does everything right in my opinion, and you can see it's also a tiny bit larger. If you take a look at thickness, you can see that it's even thicker than that one here on the Eilidon. And then we have a Weknife to compare it to, the Brad Zinker designed Miscreant 3.0, which is very close in overall form factor, as you can see here. And then we have the IQ from Quiet Carry once again, and you can see these are very similar knives, but the Eilidon just does it differently, and because of the integral nature, it's going to be thicker in the pocket. If that is no issue for you, I think this is a very cool little knife here from Weknives. They're really pushing the envelope, what is possible. And price-wise, we're looking here in US stores, it's $195. Tellknives hasn't listed it already, but when they will, there will be a link in the description below. It will be more than US prices, but if you live in Europe or Switzerland, it will be a great price. And I would highly recommend to check this out. If you like the design, if you like the unique overall nature that we have here on the Eilidon with the integral build, with this very small and very well-functioning front flipper, gorgeous, gorgeous blade shape, nice steel, very good action, and just a fun piece to have and a great piece to have in the pocket in terms of design. If you like well-designed objects, this could also be something for not a big knife guy, but just somebody that appreciates good design. This could be a perfect knife for somebody like that, or even for a woman in your life. This could also hide away very well in a purse and doesn't give away right away that this is actually a knife. So very cool design, one of the favorites that are in the lot that Tellknives sent me this time around. Here the Weknife Eilidon, just a bit of a bummer that they have some fit and finish issues right there in the pivot area. And of course there's only one screw because it's an integral, so it makes for a very, very clean overall look. So this was my overview in the show and tell series powered by Tellknives of the Weknives Eilidon. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up and put any questions that you might have in the comment section below. I read all of them and answer all of them if they are a question. And don't forget to follow me here on YouTube as well as on my Instagram, 730_knife_reviews, and check out all the links in the description, like the Tellknives website and their Instagram. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.